It's a pleasure to introduce Matthias Raja from the University of Murcia. It is the first time he's talking here, but really we are were expecting. Our pleasure to have him here, and he will talk about compact sets that admit strictly convex functions. So
thank you very much, Juan, for your kind words. Also, thank you to Josefa and Javier for this invitation. Here I want to say that I was afraid when I received this invitation, because I know what kind of stuff you like. Also, I feel that I'm somehow far from your interest, but I try to present something that I hope is suitable for this day. But this is also not yet finished. In fact, it's a work I'm doing with Luis Carlos García Lirola, Pepe Orihuela. And so, because it's not finished, I have to say that any mistake here is only for my own responsibility. And of course, misprints are also my own. This is more or less the idea. I'm going to explain the setting, but the part of topology or mathematical analysis or geometry where this result can live. I will give a motivation. I will introduce a class of compact spaces or sets. And about this class, I will prove an embedding result. I'm going to give some application to spokes, points, and faces. And finally, this is perhaps the most polemical thing, because I'll try to give a kind of variational principle. You will see why is the reason of this question mark. So the setting. This is the list of notions that I'm going to use in this talk. Compact sets is something already known for all of you. Bare property. That means that a countable intersection of dense, the open sets is dense. This is a property that is true in compact spaces, also in completely metrizable spaces. Continuity, semi-continuity, upper and lower. After the previous talk, it's not necessary to stress. Those notions. The setting also includes results in locally convex spaces, but also Banach spaces versions. Of course, convex sets and functions. Extreme point, exposed point, and phase. These are notions I like because I can explain with pictures. And extreme points, you already know that is a point which cannot be the middle point of a segment inside the set, but exposed point is something more. In the Banach space setting, exposed point is a point where a functional attains the maximum just at this point, and the phase is the situation when the functional meets many points. So this is a normal stream point, spouse point phase. But in the locally convex setting for stream for exposed point and phase, it's usual not to take functionals, but to take continuous affine functions defined on the compact set, and this gives more freedom. And I like slice is also a very important notion. Slice is a set of this kind, the intersection of a set with an open half space. Strictly convex functions norms are also very known notions. In fact, strictly convex norm is a norm such that every point in the unit sphere is a stream point of the ball. And this maybe are the most technical notions, but if you receive here people from Murcia, you know that we like fragmentability and dentability. Fragmentability means a set is fragmentable. Every non-empty set has a weak or weak star neighborhoods. I mean, with respect to a coarse weak topology, which we have a small diameter with respect to a metric topology. In the Banach space setting, this can be the weak topology, and the diameter is measured with respect to the north topology. In fact, maybe it's better that I write the notion. Suppose you have a compact with some topology, and this is a metric. We say that K is the fragmental if for every non-empty set there is a U open, for every non-empty set and for every positive epsilon open such that this is non-empty and the diameter less than epsilon. This diameter is measured with respect to the metric D, of course. So these are all the ingredients. With the respect to compact convex sets, I pick a few classical results which are important to have in mind. The Krim-Nieman theorem that tell us that the set of extreme points is non-empty and allows to and give enough information to reconstruct the compact by the convex closed convex hull. This is also something relevant. If you have a convex and upper semi-continuous function, the maximum is attained at an extreme point. And I have to say, from my point of view in Banach spaces, for me, a convex and upper semi-continuous function is something strange, because most convex functions I have are lower semi-continuous with respect to weak topologies. So you will see later the results are for this kind of functions. And this is also relevant. It's a very nice theorem of Soquet that states that the set of extreme points is a bare space. This set cannot be even Borel, but always is a bare space. And one important ingredient in the proof of Soquet theorem is the so-called Soquet lemma, which says that if you have a compact convex set, the extreme points, if you have one extreme point, then the slices around this point are a neighborhood basis for the topology. This is more or less obvious when you have a spokespoint, because even the neighborhoods given by parallel slices are a neighborhood basis. In analysis, we like because compactness is something very general. We like to study the smaller classes of compact spaces, and in particular, in Banach space theory, appears in many of them. For instance, we call Everline compact a compact space which is homeomorphic to a weakly compact subset of a Banach space. These are very nice compacts from the topological properties they have, but are not the only one. For instance, the study of differentiability properties in Banach spaces led to the Radon-Nikodym property and also the so-called Radon-Nikodym compact, also fragmentable compact. This property first appears in relation with differentiability, I guess. For instance, the Radon-Nikodym compact appears in relation with Fresse differentiability, and fragmentability is in very general setting is related to Gateau differentiability. And this classes of compacts usually contains the metrizable ones. So I would class of compact. If you are defining a new variety of compact spaces, you see, interesting that this class contains the metrizable ones, like a trivial case. And many of these properties are generalization of metrizability. For instance, if K is metrizable and the metric is a Laval semi-continuous metric, or the closed ball with respect to the metrizable topology are closed in this metric, you can prove fragmentability from the Weber theorem. So this is time for the motivation. So the motivation. Metrizability and convexity are related by this nice result. I know this classical and know of many of you, the Hervé. Compact, convex, this is in the locally convex setting. If there is a continuous strictly convex function, then K is metrizable. The opposite is true, is easy if you have a K convex compact metrizable. You can easily produce a strictly convex function, continuous on it, and the converse is true. And in particular, we have this corollary. The set of extreme points is a G delta set. This is easy to prove. And a G delta set of a completely metrizable compact space, in particular, a G delta set in a complete metric space, is completely metrizable. So what happens if the function is not continuous, just Laval semi-continuous, which is the usual in my area? You have a result of Rivaska concerning fragmentability that says that if you have a Laval semi-continuous strictly convex function, you at least you can say that the compact is fragmentable by some metric, a finer metric. As in particular, by the result around the fragmentability, K contains a completely metrizable G delta set. So there is some parallelism between the both corollaries, but not complete. There are also some results of Godefroy and Lee, and a few years ago, I can give you the references later because I don't put it in the slides. So, motivated by this result, okay, this is a motivation to introduce a new class of compact sets, which are the class SC, exactly the, in a locally convex space, the compact and convex subsets that admit a strictly convex lower semi-continuous function. In particular, by the previous result, this class is nice because contains the metrizable compacts, and is contained in a previous existing class, which is the fragmentable compact. And we also say that F witnesses that K belongs to the class. So this is the class that motivates the title of the talk. I have to say that this class is not purely topological because I need the geometry. I would like to remove geometry. There are some results of Pepe Orihuela with Ferrari and others about a property they call star, but are not quite satisfactory enough. I think that we can we'll be able to do something more topological, I hope, in a short time. And this is just what I said about the class. I will say class SC without the space in general for this kind of set. Something more about motivation. This is related to a previous work, and you will see the relation with the result of Hervé and Rybarska. If you have a compact and convex in a locally convex space, if there exists a function which is both a lower semi-continuous strictly convex and bounded, I need that. Then the extreme point of K contains a completely metrizable G delta set. Hervé result says that if the function is continuous, then the extreme points in particular are completely metrizable. But this, in this case, is the best I can do, and this result is a consequence of something related to points of continuity, which is the following. If you have a bounded convex lower semi-continuous bounded and convex function on a convex compact set, the extreme point of K contains a dense set of continuity points of F. That means, of course, I will put this in context. A lower semi-continuous function on a compact space, which is a bare space, has many points of continuity, but you don't know where these continuity points are. There are many of them, but I claim that you can find continuity points that are also extreme points, and in fact, there are many of them. The proof of this result was motivated by the geometrical construction around the Radon-Nikodym property, This is a quite simple proof, but for me, you will see later how it's used in other statements. But one application is that, and the application I'm sorry, I don't remember what follows. yes, I don't know how to remove the boundedness hypothesis, but one idea is to work with the class SC and study how behave by different operations and performing operations with the sets. Maybe you can improve the quality of the function, the witnessing function. In fact, we can prove the following things. This is more or less obvious, and this is sums. That means if you have a B here, then the sum, the convex, the usual sum, is also there. The idea of the proof, if you have a witnessing function for F, for A, and another for G, the function here is just the convolution. That function works. This is a little more technical, but that means because your sets are already convex and compact, the convex hull is also the closed convex hull, and this is in the union. And the trick to produce a function here from F and G is a kind of amalgamation of the function with a operation that maybe I can tell you later if it's already known in convex analysis or not, but this is in fact is true. This is more or less obvious also. You just sum the function and you preserve strict convexity, and this is of course this is true. You have a continuous linear map, and you have a set here, then the image is there. Of course, the image is compact, convex, also admits a strictly convex lower semi-continuous function. As a consequence of this operation, you have a set, you can take you can take the minus the set, take the union, take the convex hull, and so you can symmetrize sets. Thanks to this idea, you can improve the witnessing function, you can symmetrize the function, and you even can prove that the function can be take bounded even more. You can take the function, the witnessing function, as the square of a seminorm, which is strictly convex on the linear space generated by the set. You start with a compact, you symmetrize the compact. This is a compact, a convex, symmetric, and is a Banach disk with a generates a space which is isomorphic to a dual Banach space. So you can prove this kind of result. The asset is in the class SC, if and only if it is linearly homeomorphic to a weak star compact convex set of a strictly convex dual Banach space. This is a result that can be compared with other results already new about characterization of class of compacta that embeds into a space with a certain kind of renorming. For instance, a uniformly Everlane, which is a special kind of Everlane compact, is are exactly those that embed into Hilbert spaces or into a uniformly convex Banach space. Namioka-Fells, the compact, this is a technical definition, but it's a kind of Radon-Nikodym compact, belongs to the class if and only if embeds in a dual Banach space with a locally uniformly convex norm. I'm not going to define this kind of norms, are not necessary for the talk, but these are results that are more or less related to that one. Only one problem, uniformly Everlane and Namioka-Fells are really topological classes, not depends on the geometry as the class SC. And now we go to the relation with exposed points. This is, as I said, part of this study is motivated by the geometrical study of the Radon-Nikodym property. In Radon-Nikodym property, you have fermentability by the norm. If you have a strictly convex function, you can define this. Because of convexity, this is always bigger or equal to zero. If the function is strictly convex, this formula is zero is if and only if x equals y. So this function behaves like a metric, but doesn't satisfy the triangle inequality. This is in topology called symmetric. And there is a, with respect to asymmetric, we can consider a notion of diameter, exactly the same if you have a metric. And this fact, which is implicit in the paper about the continuity points of a stream, continuity points of convex function. The fact is the following. If you have a compact and a function which is strictly convex, bounded and lower semi-continuous, then you have slices which are rho small. The idea is quite simple. If you have a stream, you have a compact, you know that there are stream points where the function is continuous. The function is continuous, you can take a neighborhood, in particular as the stream point, the neighborhood basis is made of slices, you can take a slice where the oscillation of f is small. So fx is almost fy, and almost f of the middle point, because the middle point is also inside. So these three quantities are near between them, and so rho is small. So you can find slices which are small with respect to rho. And this is a kind of Radon-Nikodym property. As you know, Radon-Nikodym property from the geometrical point of view means that you can find slices of a small diameter if you are measuring with respect to the norm. And in Radon-Nikodym property, you prove if you have small slices, then you have strongly exposed points. And this is a very a very beautiful theory with the use of Bell category in the primal space or in the dual, depends on the context, and we can't mimic the arguments in the Radon-Nikodym theory in order to give a version with respect to rho. In particular, what you get is a rho strongly exposed points are in particular exposed points. You have a function on the space. I need the function to be defined on the whole space because I need the symmetric if everywhere because of the argument. Then you have a strictly convex this is in the Banach space. You have a dual, a weak star Lauer semi-continuous, strictly convex function, which is bounded on weak star compact set. This is because of the theorem about continuity points requires boundedness. Then the set of exposed points, which are also continuity points of F, the restriction of the function to the compact is dense in the set of extreme points. I can go to the locally convex case by a trick. In this case, I have the same result, but in that case, exposed means exposed by a continuous affine function defined on the set, not a linear functional. With these rules, this result is true. Moreover, we can prove the following. If the function is not defined on the space, I cannot. I need a strictly convex function on all the space to make the computation, but the original function appears something different, so we lose information. But at least we can prove the following. If a compact is in the class SC, then the exposed points, the exposed points of K in this sense are dense, the string points. In the literature there are not many results about the system of the exposed points. One corollary that we get, this is that one that I don't remember, but it's very simple statement. If you have a dual Banach space with a dual strictly convex norm, then it's every weakly weak star compact set, even here I can remove convexity, has a weak star exposed point. This is not true in every dual, as you can prove easily. L infinity of the continuum, the unit ball has not a weak star exposed point. I mean, this is not a characterization, but maybe working in this direction, we can be more close to the characterization, as in Radon-Nikodym property characterize the system of strongly exposed points. I don't know, maybe working a little harder. And so we go to the phases stuff. If you start with a function which is convex but not strictly convex, you may also consider the symmetric. You will see that I put squares there. This is not not a big problem, but it's of some help because if the rho of x, y is zero, then f x, f y, and f of the middle point have the same value. The argument that the argument to find a exposed point, which is more or less the following. You have a slices which are small for the symmetric. You have a slices from everywhere. This the functional giving this those slices are open and dense in the primal space, and you use a Ver category argument to find the exposed points. But you have a symmetric, a pseudo-symmetric, maybe you don't find a exposed point, but you will find a face, which is so the result is the following. You have a locally convex space, a lower semi-continuous convex function, which is a bounded or compact set. Then you can find many faces given a compact convex set. You can find many faces in the sense I already told, where the function is constant and continuous. And this result implies the result about the exposed points, because a strictly convex function is only constant on a face if the face reduced to one point. And this is the last thing, a variational principle. This is something strange. I hope you will have a variational principle. Usually provides a strong minimum for a kind of function by a certain kind of perturbations. But lower semi-continuous function already attains its minimum on compact spaces, which are my setting. So why a variational principle? This is just the things I already told you are motivated by relevant decoding property. Stigler variational principle is something nice in relevant decoding property that has a version in this setting. And this is the result. You have a compact in the class SC, a lower semi-continuous function. Given a positive epsilon, you can find an affine continuous function, small, in the sense that the oscillation is small. This double B and U is the same, so the letter that you prefer. The result states you have a lower semi-continuous function. You already know that the function attains the minimum, but a small perturbation will give you a point where this minimum is unique if the compact is in the class. If you are in a dual Banach space with the weak star topology, then you instead of this is the picture in the dual Banach space, because this is a function that not that affine function from inside. You can prove that means a small perturbation gives a point where the minimum is unique. You don't have a Bischoff-Ferr Bolovac thing here, because you choose this point where the minimum is attained, the perturbation, every perturbation sends the new minimum far from the points that you, from that point. But this is the result. I don't know if maybe this is it can be used for something or not. But it's a kind of variational principle. So this is all that I wanted to say. Thank you very much.
First of all, I would like to thank you the effort to approach our setting. You know that we have made only a shy attempt to work in Banach spaces. We are quite comfortable in RN, but we like very much the music of Banach spaces and functional analysis in general. So.
No,
this is a good opportunity for us to increase our knowledge, and uniqueness is important for us. So these ideas, I think they will be useful for sure. Perhaps. I don't know if you can ensure strong uniqueness or I don't know how resistant is this kind of uniqueness, but we are fighting with uniqueness now, so this is important. There is a big jump when you are minimizing a function. If the solution is unique, you have more tools, because you may concentrate in the information in that point, active constraints and so on. If not, you lose many information. Well, okay, any question? Well, if not,
I have one.
Excuse me, you were just there.
With this kind of variational principle, I don't know, maybe it's possible to terminate if you have this bad case of a middle point.
Yeah.
Then the picture shows that maybe small perturbations will still in the same phase. At least trying it. Of course, it will move to an extreme point.
Yes.
But maybe there is a way from this same rational principle to compute all the extreme points of this phase or something. Trying not to move too far.
Yes. So if you cannot remain on the same phase, then move or close. Maybe this seems to be true.
Maybe this is an interesting thing to look if I can recover the information of the whole arg mean from these strong means without getting too far away.
No, I want to say thank you for that, but as you say, you work in RN, and this makes sense in very non-separable context, so there is still a big gap between.
But infinite comes from the other side, from the number of constraints, so but we don't put much structure on this side, but any case, we are very thankful, and we will find the way to approach. So thank you again.